So the footage which you just saw, it was shot on this GoPro 7 Black, which was mounted on this Zhiyun Rider M gimbal. So my backyard do not have a lot of twisties, so maybe I will not be able to show you how great this thing is. But trust me, it can get you some really nice POV shots, which you normally see in the gyrocam of WSBK or MotoGP. So this is the Zhiyun Rider M gimbal, and call it a gyrocam, and this is how it looks. About the price, this costs around $399 in the US. It's like $320 in China. It's like $299 or $250. I had bought it for $299 back in 2018 or 2017. I don't remember actually. It's been a long time. And in India, it's like 57,000 Amazon India. Absolutely do not recommend to go ahead and get from Amazon India. But anyways, I have left all the links below in the description, like Amazon India, Amazon USA, AliExpress China. Get it from anywhere you can get it. This absolutely was nice. Now, who needs a gyrocam or a stabilizer for the action camera or GoPros, anything? For example, there are like three types of persons. First, if you're riding a motorcycle on the track and going through a lot of corners and twisties, this thing is going to help your footage. Any kind of shake, it's going to take it, and your video is going to look like nice straight. Second, if you are going through a road trip or doing a road trip which has a lot of twisties and corners, this thing is going to make your footage look like nice, neat. So quick unboxing, this is the box. It says Zhiyun Rider M on the back. It says what all it comes in the box. The Rider M gimbal, two batteries, the tripod stand, the GoPro mount, which supports wireless remote control, 1 second manual angle settings, compatible with most kind of cameras. It supports almost everything, SD cam, GoPro, Xiaomi cam, almost all the cameras it supports. And let me just show it to you. Okay, so this is the box, nice packaging. Here is the Rider M manual. It's in English and Chinese, so you can go through it. Here is a small nice bag, and there goes the gimbal, the Rider M gimbal. So this is the Rider M gimbal, and in the box it comes the charger, two batteries, more two batteries inside. And here is the small tripod. Then it also comes with this GoPro mount, so you can easily mount it to your chest mount or any mount you want to. Here goes the cable for charging and USB, firmware update, all that stuff. And here are more two cables to connect your GoPro to the phone and manually or remotely just manage the camera. So basically this is all what it comes in the box, and that's pretty much it. Now, how to set it up and how to connect the GoPro? All you have to do is just make those ends loose and switch on the GoPro first. Push it something like this and just make those ends tight. All right, it's set. And this is the mode button over here, and this is the switch on and switch off button, and here is the option to open this thing and put the batteries. So let's switch it on. Okay, you can see that it's on. And talking about the best settings for this Rider M, if you are using in a motorcycle, is just connect the Rider M, then go to this mode option right over here and press it once to go to the lock mode, and press it again to be, maybe this is the lock V2, but this is what it works. So basically, here is the lock mode. You can see that it's locked. But if you're taking a turn, it's going to take the turn with you, and again, you are going to stay in again this new straight line. So you have to be on the lock mode if you are using it on a motorcycle. And for the GoPro, always, always, always stay on the, if you are using a GoPro 7 Black, go to 4K 24fps, and FOV needs to be on Super View only. If you are using a GoPro 5 or 6, go to the 2.7K and 16:9, and keep the FOV as Super View. So if I have to tell you the best settings for this Zion Rider M, if you are using it for motorcycles, is just switch it on, go to the mode, this is the mode button, click it once and this goes to the lock mode. So basically if you're on a straight line, straight road, use this lock mode. So even if you're going down, up, it's going to stay right straight on the straight line. And if you have got the roads like twists, corners, click it once more, so it goes to the pan only follow mode. So basically it stays right on this axis, it doesn't go up and down. But if you are taking a turn, it's going to take the turn with you. And if you're taking this turn, it's going to take the turn like this with you. But this is not going to go down or up. This is the lock axis, it's not going to go up and down, and your footage are again going to stay right on the straight line. And about the best settings for GoPros, if you're using it with the Rider M gimbal, is use only super view, because you need more field of view for this, then only you are going to see all those nice footages. So use super view, 24 fps, no need to use 50 fps, 60 fps, just 24 25 fps, and super view, that should be it. Now about mounting this thing, you have got like two or three options. First, the best position is use it with this GoPro chest mount. And if you want to mount this Rider M to your helmet, maybe you can use it something like this, mount it over here. But the issue is it's going to block your view. So yeah, it depends. If you have a smaller helmet, maybe it's going to help. If you have a big touring helmet, it's going to help. But if you have a sports helmet, it's always going to block your view. So the best thing I always suggest and I use is with this chest mount over here, and it looks the best. Let me just show you how to fit it right now. So use the GoPro mount which came with the box. This is the one. Put it over here, straight up, lock. This is where it goes. And just switch it on. All right. And the best thing is you can actually lock the position. So if I need something over this, just lock it, and if I needed something like this, hold for 1 or 2 seconds, it's going to lock the position. If you want to have it something like this at this position, hold it and it's ready. All right, so this is how you normally fit the Rider M with the GoPro. So that's it for today, guys. If you have got any questions about this Rider M Zion gimbal, let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. If the video helped, go ahead and share with your friends. Ask them to love it, ask them to subscribe to the channel, because I keep on doing a lot of videos. So yeah, let me know if any questions. I will see you in my next video.